and then a bed, right? Two spaces for air to come out of there instead of just one. I promise you, you're gonna blow at a different pressure with two drums going than you with one, okay? And then you kick in a third one, and you try and tune it, and you say, they're not in tune. Why did I waste all that time? They're not in tune. I thought I was doing it right. Let's think about it for a minute. You tune one drone at one pressure, you tune another drone at another pressure, and you tune the third one, and that's still a third pressure, okay? Why not try and get closer to the final pressure that you're gonna play at when you're tuning your drums? If you watch any professional bagpiper getting tuned up in a contest, they never do it one drone at a time. Always a minimum of two, and most of the time it's three drones. They're tuning, all three drones are going, and they will tune all three drones at the same time. Why? Because that's the pressure that they're gonna be playing at, right? Does that not make sense? So you wanna get close to that if you can. If you can, if you could tune all three drums, have them all three going, and be able to tune them all together to each other and have them lock in with that low A and chanter, you're golden. You know, that's what you want, okay? Most of us can't do that. But with a little practice, I'll bet you that everybody in here could tune two drums going at the same time, okay? So that's what this demonstration's about. All right, now, I don't have a chanter in here, okay? I've just got this corked up, because all I'm going to do is tune drums right now. I'm going to tune drums to each other, so we get one big solid drum sound, right? And I'm going to tune two drums at the same time. I'm going to start with my outside tenor. It doesn't matter which tenor. I can start with the inside tenor. Have one tenor going, I'm going to have the bass going, okay? And this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to assume that that tenor drum is where it needs to be. So all I'm going to do, first of all, is shut off the middle tenor, and then I'm going to tune the bass to that outside tenor, so they sound like one, okay? That's step one. No chanter going. And this is a good way to practice tuning your drums, to train your ear to hear when drums lock in together to each other. It's a simple matter now to restart with that other tenor, with all three drums going, and just tune the other tenor to that so they all lock in together. Let's see if I can do it. About 3/16 of an inch of a gap right here. So I'm going to just close it up a little bit to there. Okay. I didn't mess with the bridle on the tongue. I didn't play with the tongue. I didn't flick it. I didn't do anything. All I did was just push this in a little bit to make this reed shorter and higher pitched. To compensate now, all I need to do is move this out. And you'll hear the difference, and you'll hear me tune it out, and you'll see where it ends up.
Dirty.
Other thing.